Good morning everyone. Ojaswat IAS Academy welcomes you in the series of MCQs based on daily current affairs for helping you in the upcoming exam of UPSC Prelims 2020. So today we will discuss the MCQs of 23rd March. But before that, you can download these PPTs from the link given in the description box below. And please take a pause when you see a question on the screen, answer it first and then see the explanation part. And meanwhile, if you feel the video is going too slow, too fast, please adjust the speed of the video accordingly and utilize your time properly. So work hard, be consistent, regularly watch our videos and try to get at least 7 questions correct out of 10 in the given MCQ. Increase your accuracy level. So let's begin our today's MCQ. So question number 1 is with reference to additional tier 1 bones. So first, the bones are unsecured, perpetual bones giving high rate of interest. Second, the bones are regulated by RBI and called off at the time of bank crisis. So both the given statements are correct here. So option will be here C, first and second bones. Now let's check out the explanation part. So 81, that is additional tier 1 bones, are a type of unsecured perpetual bones that banks issue to shore up their core capital base to meet the Basel III norms. Do read more about Basel III norms. It is important with the point of view of UPSC. Now, routes through which the bonds can be acquired are initial private placement, offers of 81 bonds by banks, secondary market purchase, and 81 bonds pay a higher rate of interest compared to other bonds, which is slightly higher. And there are also provisions that they can be listed and traded on the exchange. And investors cannot return their bond to the issuing bank and get the money. And these bonds are regulated by RBI. In the case of crisis, RBI can ask the bank to write off its outstanding bond without consulting its investors. Now question number 2 is with reference to non-proliferation treaty. First, it is a non-binding treaty that aims to prevent the spread of nuclear weapons. Second, India has signed the treaty but not ratified it. So here, both the given statements are incorrect. Option will be D, none of the above. So non-proliferation treaty is an international treaty whose objective is to prevent the spread of nuclear weapons and technology, promote peaceful use of nuclear energy and achieve nuclear disarmament. And the treaty is binding commitment to the goal of disarmament by the nuclear weapon state, and it was open for signing in 1968 and came into force in 1970, and a total of 191 states have joined the treaty, including the 5 nuclear weapon states. Do find out what are the nuclear weapon states or which countries are named as 5 nuclear weapon states. And the treaty defines nuclear weapon state as those that have built and tested a nuclear explosive device. So you have already got the definition, and this should be before 1 January 1967, and these are the United States, Russia, UK, France and China. So do remember it. And India is not a signatory to the treaty, so the treaty becomes important. Now, question number 3 is with reference to Eklavya model schools. First, the model schools are aimed at residential schools for minorities. Second, it is an initiative of Ministry of Human Resource and Development. So again, both the given statements are incorrect. So option will be D, none of the above. So the scheme of Eklavya model residential school is a government of India scheme for model residential school for Indian tribal across India, not for minorities, and was introduced in the year 1997. And the scheme is being implemented by Ministry of Tribal Affairs. So again, the statement second was incorrect. And these schools are set up in states or UTs with grants under Article 275, Clause 1 of the Constitution. And as per budget announcement in 2018-19, every block having 50% or more ST population, that is scheduled tribe population, and at least 20,000 ST person is to have an Eklavya model residential school by the year 2022 and to provide quality middle and high level education to scheduled class tribe students in remote area in order to enable them to avail of reservation in high and professional educational courses and get jobs in government and public and private sectors. Now question number 4 is Unnat Bharat Abhiyan is an initiative of which of the following ministries? So the correct answer is Ministry of Human Resource and Development. So option will be B. So Unnat Bharat Abhiyan is inspired by the vision of transformational changes in rural development and is an initiative of Ministry of Human Resource and Development. And the objective of this Abhiyan is to engage the faculty and students of higher educational institute in identifying development issues in rural areas and finding sustainable solutions. Other one is identify and select existing innovative technologies, enable customization of technology or device implementation methods for innovative solution as required by the people. And Unnat Bharat Abhiyan 2.0 is the upgraded version of this scheme and was launched in 2018. And as per the recent data, 13,072 villages have been adopted by 2,474 higher educational institutions. Now next question. Now question number 5 is Boko Haram, a militant group in news, is related to which of the following countries? So correct answer here is Nigeria. So option will be C. So here you can check out the image and this orange color area is the area where Boko Haram is most active. And this is militant group in North Nigeria and the militant group was founded in 2002 and term Boko Haram means Western education is forbidden. And the group initially aimed to uproot the corruption and injustice in Nigeria alleged due to Western interference and to impose Sharia or Islamic law, but has now emerged as a hardline militant organization and it has killed lakhs of people in the country, destabilized the region and has displaced more than 3 million people. Now question number 6 is with reference to Indian polity. So consider the following statement regarding doctrine of pleasure. First, this doctrine has been taken from England. Second, the doctrine of pleasure is embodied in Indian constitution. Third, the doctrine is subject to constitutional limitations. Fourth, attorney general remains in office as per the pleasure of the president of India. So here all the given statements are correct, so option will be D, all of the above. So though doctrine of pleasure is accepted in India as it has developed in England, it has not been completely accepted in India. This doctrine of pleasure is embodied in India in Article 310, Clause 1, and except as expressly provided by this constitution, every person who is a member of a defense service or of a civil service of the Union or of an All India service or holds any post connected with defense or any civil post under the Union holds office during the pleasure of the President. And every person who is member of a civil service of a state and holds any civil post under a state holds office during the pleasure of the Governor of the state. And following are expressly excluded by the Constitution from the clause of doctrine of pleasure. And these are Supreme Court judges, Auditor General, High Court judges, a member of Public Service Commission, and Chief Election Commissioner. So do remember it. It is very important. Now question number 7 is, recently social distancing was in news. So consider the following statement. First, it is a set of pharmaceutical infection control actions. Second, it is intended to stop or slow down the spread of a contagious disease. Third, it is most effective when the infection can be transmitted via droplet contact. So here statement first is incorrect. So option will be A here, one only, because this one is incorrect one. And one is incorrect because social distancing is a set of non-pharmaceutical infection control action, not pharmaceutical. And the objective of social distancing is to reduce the probability of contact between persons carrying an infection and others who are not affected so as to minimize disease transmission, morbidity, and ultimately mortality. And this social distancing may be less effective in cases where the infection is transmitted primarily via contaminated water or food or via vectors such as mosquito and other insects, and less frequently from people to people. And the drawback of this social distancing was including loneliness, produced unhappiness, and reduced productivity and loss of other benefits associated with human interaction. Now question number 8 is cloud computing constantly remaining new. So consider following statement. First, it is the on-demand availability of computer system resources with direct active management by the user. Second, cloud may be limited to a single organization. So here statement first is incorrect, second is correct. So option will be B, second only. And first is incorrect because here cloud computing means all demand availability but without direct active management by the user. And the term generally used to describe data centers available to many users over the internet. Large clouds predominantly today often have functions distributed over multiple locations from central servers. If the connection to the user is relatively close, it may be designated as an edge server, and the availability of high capacity networks, low cost computer and storage devices, as well as a widespread adoption of hardware virtualization, service oriented architecture and autonomic and utility computing has led to growth in cloud computing. Now question number 9 is with reference to Indian polity. So in which of the following condition the bill will not left even a resolution of Lok Sabha? So here the correct option is C, and option C is correct because all the other three conditions will lead to the lapse of the bill but not the third one. And cases when a bill does not lapse are given below. You can read them. They are very, very important. UPSC generally asks question over it. Now question number 10 is Satya Mangalam Wildlife Sanctuary and Tiger Reserve is located in which of the following Indian state? So the correct answer here is D, Tamil Nadu. So here you can see in the map in Tamil Nadu. It is a protected area along Western Ghat in the Erode district in the Indian state of Tamil Nadu, and first declared as a wildlife sanctuary in 2008 and enlarged in 2011. So here I am wrapping up today's MCQs. Hope you guys are liking the lecture. And in the last, positive quotation is, the best preparation for tomorrow is doing your best today. So work hard to multiple revision of these PPTs. Please subscribe our channel and press the bell icon to get the latest update of the video. Please like, comment and share the video. We will meet tomorrow with the next MCQ. Have a nice day and thank you.